He thinks I won't, but I will.
He will touch your balls.
No, because I want to know. I want to know how is.
Yo. Welcome back to the greatest show on planet Earth, Gasworks. We're back. Yeah, ready them fucking back and bigger than ever. Fucking hell, I'm tired of this shit with you, man. I think this is slowly driving me into depression.
Oh, I was in depression time ago. It was lit though.
But why would that make you sad though?
What's
because
that?
You should be happy if you're getting your depressed. Get me?
By what?
I said that last, if you're getting your depressed.
By what?
A girl, hopefully. But if you butter that side of the bread, then do your thing, my guy.
No, there's other things you can use. I plan on going to China. I heard there's little things in the wall.
Bruv, like sex robots and stuff.
Yeah.
In Japan, you got wank booths.
Wank booths?
Man, then will just, on the way home from work, will just go into a wank booth and wank.
I think that's really healthy.
Not really. Why can't you do that at home?
All right, hear this out. This is really crazy. Imagine when you were about to have a confrontation, you wanked and then made a decision if you had should have a confrontation after the wank. I think there'll be no beef. Like any type
of.
What's man saying? All right, let's wank and then we'll. Another wank. Right, do you know, I'm not really on it, you know. I'm just tired, fam. I think
the power of a wank is beautiful, you know.
Oh.
Because you can have a wank and you've just saved yourself from making the biggest mistake with a dead thing.
You've actually saved yourself money on a cab, me anyway. I've saved myself a night of pretending that I care about something. I've saved myself a good hour watching Netflix and not really watching Netflix. Like, you save so much time, then I can FIFA.
It's true. But we were actually one wank away from not being here. Think about every nut you've ever bust. That could have been, you know, the next Steve Jobs.
You could have had some real freaky parents. I reckon my dad just busted my mum's mouth. She took it in, I'm like,
oh
and
my
boom.
God.
Man's head, just like, oh, come on, can't.
Yeah. Oh my God. What's that illness when you get patchy skin?
Is that what I've got?
I don't think you've got that. I think you were straight, like, normal intercourse. But I think people that bust in.
I've got six toes, though.
I swear.
I've got loads of things wrong with me.
Really?
Yeah.
What's that delivery company? UPS, UPS. It's basically the opposite of that. That's the syndrome you'll get.
My brother. My bro.
I think I have to address something that I said in the last episode.
Go on, like an envelope.
In the last episode, I was talking about how Grime's dead, how, you know, the people that have gone clear, just, you know, I feel like they're showing the love that they need to be shown to the scene.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I spoke too soon on that one, blood. That Wiley diss track. Fam? The UK music scene this year might actually...
So did you like it?
I fucking loved it, fam.
Was it a Grime song?
Yeah, 100 million%, fam.
Did he also
the fact that Tim Westwood...
Yeah, did he go to Grime Originals?
He did go to Grime
Originals. Did a lot of people go?
A lot of people went.
So is Grime dead?
On that day, it was rebirth.
That's not the question I asked.
Yes, right now, Grime... No. Sorry, I'm doing the politician's answer. Grime is not dead, poet. Okay. So, thank you very much. Thank you, Skepta. How would you describe today's guest? Mad gap tooth, though. Mad. How can you give head with your mouth closed?
Wow.
Nuts.
The thing is though, yeah, this is actually one of my best friends.
Really?
He's one of my closest friends. He's a really good guy. My only problem with him at one point was he smelled, but he's over that now.
Mm.
Yeah, he used to fart all the time.
He is disrespectful to smell. I remember you said that.
No, but he carries his wins like he carries his kids.
None other than the greatest fucking man from North London. Sorry, second greatest from North London. Actually, third greatest from North London because we're both there. Is the madman, Steve-O. Welcome. What are you saying, my guy? No?
Well, the gap teeth thing, yeah?
No. Was that me? I didn't say that. That was funny.
I didn't say that.
No, you know what? I've embraced the gap.
Yeah?
You have to, bro.
Don't go!
You have to say mind the gap every now and again, do you know what I'm saying?
You know the guy.
What's that smell? You smell good.
I sprayed it. You said that smell. That's Tom Ford. That? Tom Ford vanilla, yeah?
no, nickel
boy ting, yeah? But the guy that says mind the gap, he passed away last year, man.
Good stuff, man. Good stuff. No, is
history,
it
history.
Any a woman that says it?
Sometimes they change it, but the man, the original guy, please mind the gap.
Yeah.
Yeah, he passed away.
He died. Only you would know that.
It's important to me.
What do you look like?
I don't know. It's a voice, bro. It doesn't matter what he looks like.
So maybe he never passes, because he's always got the voice.
Yeah, his legacy lives on.
Yeah, his legacy lives on.
Yeah. From now on, we're not actually allowed to say man, woman, and these things. It's just person, bro. It's really offensive what you just done there. But it's calm,
it's
man.
It's true.
I don't know if you've seen my Instagram. I identify as a tree. So it'd be tremendous if you just, you know, let me know that I'm a tree.
Yeah, come on, again.
It's a palm tree, innit? Do you know why a palm tree is like that?
Go on.
Because there's no... it's in hot countries. So they grow tall to reach...
For shade.
Is it for shade or something like that?
You look like a palm tree. I look like your hair.
I look like an oak tree, I think.
You're
like
letting it grow, innit?
Like a Christmas. Yeah, it's growing, it's crazy, man. I might have to get a tree.
Have you got ends in the middle?
Let it grow.
Yeah, it's true. It's true. It's true.
Come on, I'm on there to
do
this.
No, I'm on there to do this,
man. You're on it.
This is the show, this is the show.
I'll see you doing what, team?
This is the show, fam. Steve-O the Madman, the question we like to ask every special guest, are you a Bo-Cat?
Yes. And not, thank you,
good. A real man.
I couldn't wait to come on the show and answer that. And you know why? Because I grew up in Enfield, yeah, where you walked out of your house, you got called a nigger. No word of a lie, right?
Anything changed?
It's changed. Oh, it's multicultural now. A lot of your people up there, all along the road. Looking like Green Lanes right
Young
now.
Mediterranean,
yeah?
Fam.
But I like it. I'm not mad. I can go shop at 3 a.m.
The way you
said
a lot of your people. You see,
yeah,
man.
That was a bit. I hear you. You see, man.
I like your people.
And I've realised there's no flag over there to address the people in which he's speaking. So right now.
Oh, shit.
I don't know, fam.
Hey, is Tommy Hilfiger racist? I heard this.
I think it is.
He said he didn't want black people in his clothes.
Well, take a look at them flags, mate.
Who does he share a name with? Tommy Robinson.
Exactly.
And I've seen Tommy Robinson stand on top of a mountain and he was a hill figure. So it is racist.
He's right about everything he just said.
A mountain's not a hill.
What do you mean?
A mountain is a mountain, a hill's a hill.
How would you know?
Because I've been to the Peak District.
See these white family holidays, Centre Park, Butlins.
What was I saying anyway?
Why is there a Sweden flag there?
Talking about being a Bo-Cat.
Bo-Cat! Yeah. So growing up in Enfield in the 90s, I was the only black guy in the ends.
In the whole of Enfield?
For a little while.
Until
the NF started recruiting black people to catch me. I couldn't be caught, I was too quick.
Who's NF?
National Front.
Right.
It's all mad. It's changed now. Yeah. Everything has changed.
It's NFL now, yeah.
But bro, in my day, all my friends, because they were white, ate Nani. So I thought it was normal.
This is the thing. If you go to Essex, it's not even a question over there.
Bro, you mad if you don't
them
know
man get
dickhead.
Their own ass eaten. So for them to eat us, it's nothing.
Yours is hairy, isn't it? Yeah. Yours would be a problem.
Stop it. How hairy is your ass? Is it like when you wipe your bum that like you feel the hair come off?
I ain't finished yet. This is my thing, right? Sorry, lads. So fast forward, I then start moving with my black friends. I went to a black school, Kingsmead. Mm. Lived in Enfield, went to school.
My brother went.
When you say black school, was it just for black people?
Very cultured.
Yeah, right?
So then
grey suit, red ties.
Yes.
Was it a black school or a mixed school?
It was mixed, but
Jamaicans and
weren't many whites. You could count the whites in the school.
That's nice.
Mad.
It's
for once, exaggeration.
But anyway,
in a shit
so when I started telling my black friends
that you eat pussy,
bruv, they didn't want to even talk to me.
So you were doing it from early,
bruv. This is what I'm trying to tell you. What? I set the plate up.
Soldier Boy's out there saying this. I started this and this that. I like what he started. You're saying you wouldn't take
man
credit.
Man was eating Nani when it wasn't cool. That's all I'm saying.
Because when wasn't it cool? I don't know. The people in the world need
man
answers.
Didn't want to share zoots with me. P-Jam, he had a cup for me in his house, just
all right,
for me.
I'm asking you when, big man?
I
was eating Nani by the time I was 17.
He was eating it from 17.
I've been eating Nani in 17 years.
Good.
That's my guy, my brother.
You're 34? When you were 17 or 17 years?
When he was 17 and he said he'd been eating it for 17 years, so he's
35. I heard that you just put a clip between the gap and your tooth.
Yep.
30, bruv, 30.
Hannibal Lecter thing.
Yeah, you know when you're in a car wash and you go through the spinning things and the car drives through, like that, fam.
Is that your teeth? Like that. Does your teeth spin round as well?
No, I don't spin, but I can get it in
That'll
there.
Be lit, though.
This is a serious matter, though, lads. This is very serious.
Okay. Yeah, no, it's very serious. Yes. I rate that.
At
Thank
the moment,
you.
Though, eating bum's not cool, innit?
I think
you
it is
eat
cool.
bum, though, innit?
I think
eating
it is
bum's
cool.
not cool. Give it another 17 years.
I think we both do that.
Everyone be doing it.
You eat bum?
What's that? Hey!
Steve, what are you telling us, man? You're a businessman. Well, you've been a businessman for a minute, but you're now a restaurateur. Is that what they call it?
Yes! And I found that out recently.
Is it?
Oh, is it French? Yeah, entrepreneur, restaurateur.
Yes.
I don't like the French though, man. Bunch of racist scumbags.
Bruh.
The French and the Australians, they're a bunch of cunts. Australia is the dumbest country in the fucking world. How can you border the ocean?
They bordered the what?
The ocean.
They built a wall for the ocean.
Blood, no, but they border it. Like, you know, France borders fucking, what is it, Germany, the UK borders Scotland. Mm-hmm. How can a country border water, blood? You can fall
so
off.
So you can go into Australia without actually stepping foot on the land?
What do you mean?
You're saying there's a border to prevent you from coming to Australia?
No. I'm just saying like it borders the ocean. But what's the restaurant saying though, man? Fuck France and Australia.
It's tough, bro. It is real tough.
I respect your honesty.
I had to fire someone the other day, bro.
Fire someone.
Good.
Everyone in their bios say boss and all of this crap.
Yeah.
Like,
CEO.
To actually be a boss, yeah, it's tough. And for me, I'm an empath in it, so I feel shit. And probably like a whole week, man was feeling that for that person, you know what I mean?
Why?
Because they weren't really great. They were decent, but not great. And if it's me, I could deal with probably a little bit of decent and that and get along and take shots with my staff and all of that. But for the brand of the shop, it needs greatness. You know what I mean?
It's why do you feel bad? Because you're a good man, I hate you.
I'll get over it. That's the hardest part, is the people, running the people, innit? Mm. So when people walk in the shop, they're meant to be, the front of shop's meant to be standing up. But, okay, so no one comes in, they're standing up for nothing. So I've like to the guy, I said, come sit down, man. And the guy that's come down from the franchise that's teaching us, he's like, no, she's got to stand up, because if someone comes in, they've got to be standing up. So I feel bad for that. I feel like, come sit down, rest your legs,
that's
man.
That's like the army shit, man.
Big man, that's the path they took.
I know.
Say to someone, I'm going to employ you, and you have to stand up here all day, and then you want to sit down, why did you agree, big man?
Mm-hmm. Nah, but there's standing for no reason for standing. If you're working in Selfridges and there's people
working. That's the reason why you're standing. This is an agreement. How can you get angry about something you told yourself that you're going to do? You know what letter that
I'm
is?
I'm learning.
What letter is that?
L.
Massive. Ah.
You've got a very good way of dealing with people that give you a lot of stick.
Yes.
A lot of people just resort to racism when they're trying to troll you, innit? Whether it's like black
I
this
don't
or black
mind
that.
That. You know why?
Mm. Go on.
Because I know and they are ignorant. Ignorant. They're so ignorant. Even today with the Liam Neeson post, I've just put up. The level of racism in the comments is just, I'm over that now.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? We'll deal with that when we get a bit bigger. We'll do it on a bigger scale.
But when you first started and you started receiving messages like that? Because
I used to get mad. Oh, I used to jump at them ones there. Yeah. Sorry to interrupt, but yeah, bro. I made a t-shirt though, they used to call me Gollywog. I don't know why, but the word Gollywog was getting thrown at me a lot. And to switch it around on them, I made the Snapchat logo into a Gollywog. So I made it black with a gap teeth.
Yeah.
And I sold t-shirts and I called it Gollygosh. Yeah? Made couple bags off of them, bruv. So sick. From an early stage, I've been switching the racism and whatever they throw at me.
And owning it.
Yeah. These people, they're not like that in real life.
Yeah.
100 trillion percent. You know what I mean?
You say that though, but they comment with their real name and
yeah, no, but they're still, it's still.
Really them, do you know why I know this as well? Because when man's a bit older, I remember the two generations. And because obviously this younger generation are trying to make it seem real, but 6ix9ine's really in prison. Really snitching, and 6ix9ine comes out and 2060,
69. Yeah, that's
so
nuts.
It's like,
how can a judge? He's 22. How can a judge give him 47 years?
That is fucked.
That's banter.
And I
that judge is bad mind.
Now that's real, because now all them people that thought that 6ix9ine was never going to prison have to understand that even when he comes out on road, he's gonna get killed.
And all the people that think Soulja Boy is doing a 6ix9ine, no. Totally different. Totally different. Totally different.
Fuck Soulja Boy, man. If
whatever,
I
man.
Face to face with him, I'd snuff his head in, bro.
What's that noise?
Soulja Boy, bruv. What's that noise? I bring that.
You are there?
Yeah.
Ooh, levels.
That's trust me, dog. Hey, Farrick, come and
depth.
Sniff this,
that's
you
got
prick.
Depth, fam. That's got
you're
depth.
One of them people that go, ooh, he farted, but you do it at home. Probably smell them yourself. Yeah? Fuck you, man.
Steve, at what point, listen, this is what I say to everyone here. There's marriage, there's like Valentine's Day, there's relationships, there's an engagement. A real sign of love is when you can comfortably fart in front of your missus.
Nah, mate. Yeah.
That's a real sign of love. Yeah. My girl farted 9 times in front of me on her anniversary.
Oh, your girl farted
for
you?
Yeah, she farted in front of me.
What is that, the farting version of what happened to 50 Cent? You think I want anyone to fart at me 9 times?
That's a lot, man.
How can an arsehole be screaming Church Road? Nice. You
you're an idiot.
Does Emma fart?
Twice.
In your whole life?
16 years, yeah. 16
twice?
Years.
Nah,
twice? I'd be concerned.
No, but the thing with Emma, and it pisses me off, because we'd be watching a movie, and rather than let it out, she'll hold it in.
And you can hear it in our
hey, bruv!
You can hear it in a million.
See when you're holding farts. When you're holding farts.
Bruv, let it out, brother.
Let it go.
Yes.
When you're holding farts, yeah, it feels like you've got fetus made out of acid.
Yes.
Like, it's butters, yeah, bruv. Horrible. It just has to get out
and
of there, man.
She blamed her, so when the first fart she did.
Why don't you just walk to the bathroom?
I'll tell you that in a minute. But see, my family, they're weird, bro. They're very, very weird. But the first time I heard her fart, she tried to blame the dog. Yeah? Yeah? And you know the worst thing about it? You know what pissed me off the most about that?
Yeah?
Is her mum went, bloody old boss tried to blame the dog as well. Fuck off, Sheila. Always trying to look after your daughter, bro. She farted, innit? Pisses me off, bruv.
About the second time she farted?
The second time she farted,
was Sheila there?
No, Sheila wasn't there, bro.
Did she own up to that one?
No, she was in labour, so I shouldn't really judge her on that. She's in labour.
She was in labour.
I said, you let one out there.
Fuck, yeah,
you tried to hold it as well.
We can let her off on that one.
Yeah, let her off.
I think she should fart more than Emma. Fart more.
I recorded that as well. I recorded that labour and the baby.
You recorded the fart as well?
If you listen close, I know when it comes. You know what I mean? But if you listen closely, if you've got headphones on, yeah. Yeah.
You can hear it. I want surround sound to hear a fart. Yeah,
I'll send you in a minute.
Your family's all over the internet.
Yes.
The kids have got an Instagram page as well. Mm. It's 30, fam. I love the way you're so open. It's like you've opened all your doors.
Yeah, we've opened a certain part of our life.
Yeah, I hear that.
I mean, there's still shit that goes on that no one knows, obviously. Yeah. But I let you see what you want to see, and what you believe is what you believe.
Good, fam. But is that...
I've done that voice.
What's it like in school for
I asked them this. I know what you're going to say. What's it like for school for the girls?
Yeah.
I asked them all the time because I want to know, are they famous?
Because they're famous. Yeah, famous
I want to know, innit? Because I think I'm famous.
They got more followers
than me,
but
the family tell me I'm not. They tell me I'm not. Even when I was on celeb coach trip the other day, farting up the place, live on TV, making Emmerdale people run off the coach, pick up nasty. Still not famous, she said. This is the missus, you know what I mean? So they try and keep me grounded, but I said to the babies, I said to the
she
girls.
She wanted the house.
Proper. I ground my kids all the time. They done 54 weeks last year.
Of what? Ramadan?
No, groundation. I grounded 54 weeks last year.
For more than, what do you mean last year? 54 weeks is more than a year.
They're still grounded.
I grounded them for
permanently. You know, you get permanently excluded.
Yeah.
I think you're lying. I don't.
Really?
For someone that feels a way about firing someone, you grounded your kids for 54 weeks.
You mad? I am the person that's, soon as we start doing riots and shit about bringing the beats back for the kids, I'm there, front line. Yeah? With a belt.
For
trust
54
me.
Weeks, that's evil.
I went like this.
With the belt.
So you're bringing in the black people them's movement to the youth.
Yes.
Is this how powerful
brother,
it is?
Poet, why and you will find out soon. I see your kids are going to be wild, bro.
They beat up some youth the other day.
Thank you, I see it, bro.
Two of them.
Would you ever slap your kids?
Never.
You have to.
I haven't slapped my kid. But listen, stop. Yeah. My mum didn't need to slap me. And you know what it's like, bro? This need to look.
That's why you got teeth like that. Because if she conked your head a couple times, your jaw would have realigned and maybe you I can't imagine you with I love you, Steve.
Your jaw would have realigned.
I can't wait to have kids and just bang them on in the face.
No, bro.
You can't do it.
If my daughter ever posted a photo in her pants or something, you see some of the photos I see today on Instagram, if that was my daughter.
I do hear where Aaron's coming from.
I would snuff her head in.
Could you imagine the beats we got as kids, right?
Yeah, they
have social media.
If because Emma's white, if you married a black woman, they'd be fucking getting banged every day. Fucking
Liam Nelson!
Because white people don't look after their kids right.
Hey,
it winds me up.
No.
It winds me up.
Ow.
Brown and black parents forever.
Touch him. Calm him.
Oh, chill.
Sorry. Because, bro, I get it. And it's right. And I say it to Emma all the time. But, because I always generalize it and speaking to my Spartans, my people, I've noticed that white people used to get beat too.
Bear my friends used to
Yeah, we generalize, man. White people got beat too, bro. I heard my brethren Martin, we got home late. I heard him getting beat from across the door as I'm walking. Listen. Yes, bro, he's
an Irish. Steve-o.
My Irish Steve-o. One time I had to hold back the mum like it's not
worth it. Trust me, bro.
I've heard my friends. I've got a brethren called Jamie. Man told his mum to fuck off.
Yeah, all of that. Yeah, I've seen them as well.
Come on.
That could never happen in the black household, but the whites get away with it. I get it. Yeah.
Fuck off.
Are you serious? I'd have to fuck off.
Yeah, it's true.
She did reverse 21 Savage, fam.
So my kids at the moment, if they be bad, there's not really much I can do except for take their phone off them.
No, that's how deep it is, bro.
Like the look doesn't work. I gave Casey the look the other day. I was like, I went for so long, I started shaking and shit, yeah? My eyes went all red. She went, mummy, she called mummy. I was like, she gets it. I'm still staring at her. She went, mummy, something's wrong with daddy. She didn't get it. She didn't know what it meant. So it's when my mum, she used to give me one little look.
Yeah, that's
sometimes
it.
I would take the piss until she started shaking a little bit. That was it, the shake was the living beats, bro.
But sometimes you grow too old and the look don't work no more.
I'm not too old though. My look strong, bro.
Fam, I used to get hit, yeah? My mum would hit me around the face with a slipper. I'd look in the mirror, the imprint of the bottom of the slipper would be on my blood. I can't wait to have kids. They're getting
I had
blood.
A belt print on my back for
They're getting
days,
yeah, bro. Are you dumb, fam? You have the two fucking Gucci G's on the
back,
fam.
Yes, bro.
I was always a class clown, and the teacher would say to the other students, just don't pay him attention. And then you see when you don't get the reaction, it kills you.
When
I used to
get ignored.
I've been there. When you're trying to crack jokes and no one even bats an eyelid, it's over.
And then you do that awkward laugh to yourself, man. Say fuck your mother, say something.
My little girls are good girls. But it's sometimes like...
Got a boyfriend now, innit?
Sluta.
Is that the one that was around your house the other day?
Sluta.
It was cute though. and he busts him with the trainers as well. Yeah. That's why I love you, Steve-O, man.
Oh, not that one.
I wish you were my...
That was that's a man.
How many points your girls got?
Nah, it's not that. She's with an Asian boy. He's half Asian, half Irish.
When you say Asia, what part?
Pakistan.
Okay, Biryani babes. Biryani babes.
Yeah.
That's some good food there, you know. You should get him in the kitchen for the ISO.
Trying. Sushi. Oh, no.
I can mix, man.
Trying to get him in the kitchen with Emma. Trying to get him to add some spice, yeah.
Actually, he's some good seasons.
Kid. Yeah, he's good.
You're trying to get him to teach Emma how to cook.
Yeah.
What is it? Cheerios, beans on toast, spaghetti oops?
For me?
Yeah.
Nuggets is the one we have a lot of, yeah.
Is it Bird's Eye as well?
No. Bernard Matthews.
Who the fuck's that?
The best chicken nuggets are from Costco.
I've heard this. They come like the ones from McDonald's,
like,
no?
Not that. They're better. They're like proper crispy, breaded.
He bit his lip.
Emma's doing her own range of nuggets soon.
Is it?
Serious? Mm.
But she doesn't put her face out there.
It's good.
Does she not like the fame?
No, it's just something I've done as a part of the show, really.
Because I like that, you know? Yeah, I think it's sick.
The concept of like that voice.
Tom and Jerry, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Ready? Super Bowl thing, yeah? Okay.
Bruv, come on! Better than that, bruv.
Higher.
Oh, it's me.
It's the gap, man.
Let's take it high.
Hey! Olé!
What's coming up? What's in the works?
I feel like I can say this now. I've just signed a development deal.
Have you?
Yeah.
You're setting up a production company.
Yeah. I've got my own production
company.
What's it called?
Come on. It's exclusive. You wouldn't talk about it on live with Hacks, but I know you can talk about
it. Is it? You say that?
Come on.
It's called Digestive.
Digestive?
Yeah, Digestive
nice.
Productions. Easily digestive entertainment, and that's what we're going
for. You've made the production company.
Cool. Yeah, man.
Round of applause.
I'm trying.
Really happy.
Only 6 months, but
that's good though.
Still,
help them with some programs and.
Who?
I'm not going to say who.
Calm.
But I'm just going to say.
Calm. Jedward.
The first program that we're developing is not Jedward.
Yeah.
Yes. That's all I'm saying.
No.
Come. Allow me, boys. Allow me. That's proper what I've just said there.
No, you have Digestive Productions.
Yeah.
I'm just going to do. You do Digestives. I'll do Rich Tea. I'll do Rich Tea, man, because that's my favourite biscuit, man. I've never really been a fan of digestives. Or what's the oat ones?
Hobnobs.
Not hot, but yeah, what? Hobnobs is a trademark, though. What are them biscuits called?
McVitie's Hobnob, no?
Fig Roll TV. That's going to be my one. Fig Roll TV.
That's not oats, though, bruv.
Man, what's it like when you go parents' evening?
Oh.
They must love you at parents' evening.
Obviously, you got to remember, I snapped my life, innit?
Yeah.
So. They didn't like it, bro. So
dude, the school.
I reckon the teachers hate you, fam.
Yeah, man. So it's Casey's head of year. Used to be Leah's teacher, Mr. Lewis.
Yeah.
Bad boy. Wicked for the school. Wicked for the kids. He's good. He likes me. He understands. He's watched me and gets it. Like, if you don't watch me, you just see me pop up cussing white people or you miss the whole point of what I'm doing. But he gets it, innit? So
I think teachers are annoying, you know?
A lot of them.
I think some.
Generalize, bro, because there's a Mr. Lewis out there that we're generalizing. Like,
you're
saying all teachers, but there's a Mr. Lewis.
I didn't say all teachers. Teachers in general are annoying.
I never used to get to school,
you know.
Thank you.
I know it's mad to think.
Yeah.
But teachers, you lot are fucking like my technology teacher. How can he not mark our work for 6 months? I said to him, do you know, I'm calling in my mum. The day my mum comes in, all our work's marked. I said to him, look me in my eyes. Because I said, I can't lie to our mum because she will beat me. Look me in my eyes right now and tell me you marked this from early. I marked this from early. I said, mum, I promise you on everything, on the Mega Drive, on the Super Nintendo, he didn't mark this. She looked at him and said, listen, you're a fucking liar. I said, damn, my lover! Right. Teachers are trash, fam.
My dad's calm. We've never heard him swear. He used to be a West Ham season ticket. He used to roll with the West Ham. All of that, right? So my mum had a bad relationship before and he made sure that she didn't see nothing what she saw. So he didn't stop swearing. Greatest guy I know, my dad.
Yeah,
he's sick, right?
That's why he's such a good guy.
Every now and then he switches and he don't swear. So I've seen him switch one time on the woman. She got me in a Chinese can I say Chinese burn? We're allowed to call it that. We're politically correct now. So
fuck it all.
No, we are. I'm growing up, lads, man. Trust me.
Nah, man.
And he went, he had to go at this
Chinese
woman.
What the fuck? Nah, I don't want to talk to you.
Chinese burn.
Chinese burn, bro.
1 second on Bloodsport. That's an actual move. You get it and you grab it and it like, flings them over. It's actually called
Yeah, but the Chinese thing, Steve,
what
they've
done,
man.
They're just doing it.
It comes from China. With the
how do you know?
I don't know about the Kumite, bro.
You're saying Chinese people deserve to get burnt?
You really are a madman.
Fuck off, man. It hurt my neck. Hey, before you tell your mum's story, You see the one or two wanks away from not being born. How serious is that?
A wank is basically mass genocide.
So he's killing all the things, yeah.
Yeah, because there's thousands of potential humans that you've now prevented from having a life. How dare you?
Yeah, but they say you didn't want to bring them anywhere warm.
What does that mean?
Like, for example, the vaginas I've been to are quite warm. They're not worthy of the sperm in which I have a lot of them. Mm-hmm. So therefore, I'd rather just put them on the roads. Wow.
Well, you wank on the road? What's that called?
Wow.
What's that called when you wank on the roads?
Or in the tissue?
Public. Or right, do you wank on your belly?
Nah.
No.
Do you know how I do it?
Do you wank on the belly or wank on the tissue?
I wank on my belly.
No, I don't wank on the tissue. I put a towel on my belly and lay back and then I bust on the
that's
towel.
That's too much, no, bro. Let it out, let it free.
Where?
Clean up after.
What?
Let it clean up after, man.
So you bust on man?
I bust on myself.
And you are a man?
I bust on You're, myself.
At the end of the day, when you come, it ends up on the man. That's gay as fuck.
But I'm not a man.
Whoa, Alhad.
What?
In 2019,
there's nothing
my
wrong with being gay, but it's gay.
Wrong. Wow. My best mate's gay. Hold that, Ashton.
I didn't say it's wrong to be gay, but I'm saying if you come on man, you're gay.
Nope. I've had a threesome before back in the day, way before Emma.
What, another guy?
Yeah.
No, it's called a battery. No, it's not a threesome. No. Unless you were touching the other guy, I couldn't even
do a threesome with two women. It's disgusting. Because sex is supposed to be intimate between you and someone else, G. What's the third party getting involved for? It doesn't work like
Who's
that, man.
Third party?
The other person. Right. And the fact that you've had a threesome with another man.
Did you cross swords? Pause, 1 second. Did you touch the other guy?
Now, what do you mean by that? Because we tagged when we was coming in and out. Right,
man had the relay race.
So basically, my female cousin tried to one day confess to us, like, she's had a bad part. She's like, yeah, I once had a threesome. So I was like, oh, raw, like, who's the other girl?
No, my kids are watching this, don't have threesome.
Then she said to me, no, it was two guys. I said to her, darling, did the two guys touch each other? She said, no. I said, what happened, darling, was it was a battery. They just went one after the other. Everyone indulged with practice with you. No one else touched each other. So you batteried this guy.
No.
And it sounds horrible and it's disgusting.
No.
And we should be ashamed.
What, battery?
Yeah,
I did battery. No.
It's
me
disgusting.
And my brethren made love like to a girl.
You and your brethren made love.
We
hold
both
on, hold
liked
on, hold on.
Her.
You and your brethren made love.
What?
You and your brethren made love.
Because my kids can be watching this, yeah?
You and your brethren
made
love.
I don't want you to ever think that I just go around having threesomes. You know what I mean? But I mean, definitely didn't battery. Yeah?
Yeah,
we
go
both,
on.
We both
point that finger. Whatever.
We both liked
we
her,
we didn't
bro.
Battery.
Hold on.
We just fucked her one after the other.
Yeah, you looked at his penis. Don't lie about
a million
these
times, bro.
This is the thing. It's odd.
All right, whatever, man. Call me what you want to call me. I'm me. I'm unique.
What was the original question? How did we start? How did we get in?
Oh, you just... I just... We were talking about your mum.
Yeah. That was it. In school, imagine what I'm like now.
Inshallah.
School was 3 years ago for me, Steve-O, yeah? 3-4 years ago.
Wow.
Blood, I'm 19, fam.
Is he 19?
I'm 19.
Oh, it fucking makes sense.
School was recent, yeah?
I'd love to
be 19 again, G.
Parents' evening, yeah? No matter what the teacher said, my mum would stick it on them, yeah? I had a French teacher called Miss Nye. I fucking hated her. The teachers are all on tables, innit? Then you go to that teacher, then that teacher on parents' evening. So all the teacher had to say about me for 20 minutes was how bad I am. I talk, I do this. 20 minutes is all she spoke about. My mum goes, and what are you doing about it? And she didn't know what to say.
Isn't it?
So you've called me here in parents' evening. Blood. I was like, go on, mum. That's my mum.
Can
mommy.
I say that, though?
That's my mum.
Listen, that's my mum.
Teachers always have something bad to say. He's very smart, you know, he uses his brain, but he just talks too much in the car home. You fucking cunt. You're embarrassing me there. Yeah. You're embarrassing me there. Straight home, blood. I will get slapped.
I rate that, though.
I will get slapped.
But she defends your honour in front of anyone.
Yeah. But I knew, yeah? And the first ever parents' evening, I was gassed. I was like, my mum loves me.
You just say it straight out there.
Listen, let everyone hear the truth.
What?
I ain't got time to lie. I ain't got time to make stuff up. If I done something wrong, my mum would slap me in front of everyone. And she would say, life is a lot more harsher than what I'm doing right now. You'll get over this embarrassment.
The thing is,
if you fuck up out there later on,
it's true.
You're gonna want the slap.
What I can't rate though, the parents that, you know when they do these humiliation videos and make a point out of their kid and then put it online?
Bro, that is the biggest amount of trash.
That is being a tramp. That is actually what being a tramp is.
You know what though?
When they slap up their kid on camera
or when they
and then show them off. Like a bull, why has anyone got to do with your business?
It's a funny thing you said there now. Big up your mum, she defended your honour even though she think
she was
a cunt, whatever, right? Because I get a lot of it now where parents think that I am their kid's parent.
Yeah.
Yeah, you must get it all the time. You got, you're a role model, blah,
I
blah, blah.
I stay far away from school, Steve, right? But yeah.
But are we sending our kids to school for them to teach our kids manners and all of that?
I think so. I do think so. I don't know though, but there's basic things like discipline and respect that if you're not even teaching your own kids that at home, mm-hmm. it's not down to the school's not the be all and end. The school starts at 9 and finishes at 4:30. It's as simple as that. The minute they come home, what's happening then? How are they at the dinner table?
Because
are they on an iPad all day?
For you to come into school,
yeah.
and for a teacher to, for you to be talking, ow, you're yeah. talking, blah, 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 fuck this, fuck that, grind, boom, yeah? And teacher comes up to you and says, ow, can you be quiet, please?
Yeah.
You're going to say, what? Shut up, man. So the only thing for him really to discipline you is to say, ow.
Yeah. Jesus yeah. Christ. Yeah.
Shut up,
I'm
bro.
I'm skinny.
And that's not allowed no more.
It's not.
You know what I mean?
But that's why it's down to the parents. Parents, like I said earlier, start slapping your kids a bit more, you get me? Listen, if I ever had kids like this, yeah, I just want to chunk them like that, you know what I'm saying?
We went to a restaurant the other day, on Sunday, when I was in Sweden. We're eating this food in this place called O'Leary's. It's probably the
in
worst.
In Sweden?
Yeah,
Irish.
O'Leary's, yeah.
It's O'Leary's here as well, isn't it?
Either way, the food was terrible. I didn't like it, she didn't like it, the uncle didn't like it, the kids didn't like it, but she tried to force the kids to eat it.
Why?
I looked at this woman like, babe, you know no one likes the food. But they have to eat. I said, so do we, big man. Mm. I thought back to when I was young. My parents done that to me all the
all
time.
The all the time. Is it because they I come up from a place where
my
they couldn't waste?
Was
come on.
A miserable woman. I hated her speaking sometimes.
I bet your mum.
She's amazing now because she's got over
yeah,
that.
Yeah,
she's,
yeah.
She's incredible.
My mum's different now.
It's
brother, I can't even shout at my kids or do anything.
Nah, yeah, my mum's on me.
Yeah, yeah.
Ah, yeah, do it. Yeah. Me. She threw a vase at me, woman.
That's mad. My mum bottled my brother. But then he turned that into a plus. He turned
it
into a plus.
See it?
His name's DJ Scarface, because he got a big scar on his face, and that's what they call him, Scarface. His mum went mad. Sliced him. My mum was crazy.
See, I grew up as an only child.
I love you, mum.
So I never had my siblings
yeah, she's mental.
Around.
Is it?
Yeah. Blood.
What do your brother and sister think of you?
My sister loves me. My brother loves me as well. I think my brother is the reason I can talk so much smack.
Oh, is he a bad man?
Yeah.
Is it?
So I'm sick. You might actually know him. He's from Ferry Lake.
What?
Might, from very late?
You're only the same as now.
Hold the phone.
Blood, I'm protected. This is why I talk smart.
Oh, he's only just saying this now, man. Is that your bro?
Yeah.
He's kidding everyone.
Sorry, everyone.
Try me, people.
Bruv, can you sneeze and fart at the same time?
I don't know. You probably dislocate something.
Mad. Like, what way does your body go?
Did you know if you finger a girl and she sneezes, it'll break your finger?
100%.
Yeah. Because
yeah.
of the force.
Even if they cough sometimes.
What?
Yes. If a girl sneezes while your finger's in her vagina, it'll break.
Trust me.
It breaks.
What happens?
Because it just clenches. Yeah. And everything clenches. It's like, crush.
They say
I ain't got foreskin.
Have you?
No.
Are you circumcised?
No, I'm circumcised. Yeah.
Okay. Are you? It's so nice and clean, but I've
got much more cleaner.
I've got my skin.
You have
it's
to
not actually
like pulling
cleaner,
back shit, man.
The thing is, yeah, there's a couple cars. There's certain cars that the roof comes up and down, but we have kept the top off forever.
I had a top off.
So it's mad sensitive.
Yeah.
But
I had mine done when I was a young kid, man.
Yeah, I got mine done when I was 11.
Oh, and I was younger.
Did they give you the skin in the bag?
Yeah.
Is
and,
it?
And Turks, they put it in rice or something. It's mad. There's a weird culture.
It?
Don't know if they eat it.
Oh.
But why are they putting it in rice?
Yeah, what the fuck?
I don't know. I think if you find it, you get money or something.
Rice and peas, you got rice and skin.
Actually, no.
So
let
me get it straight. They put your skin in rice and then
I think I've got it wrong.
Look
I think
for
I've
the
got
skin.
It wrong. No, but they give you a foreskin in a bag. Actually, I think I have it. I've got like a memory box. I think my foreskin might be in
it. Is
it?
That's disgusting. Yeah, that's mad. How about your balls? Are they big?
I've got huge balls. I have got huge balls.
Mine come
like
and go.
They're like camel.
What, but yours stay like that all the time? Because mine sometimes.
No. They can clench up and go into like a disco ball.
Why?
Compact.
And then drop. Then it'd be.
So annoying
like,
that you
I don't like
there.
Wearing boxers. I'm telling you. I like wearing the wide fronts.
I wear
them. Because
I'm
they keep your balls, it's nice and compact.
I it makes me cough and shit, man. But
so your balls make you cough?
Because if you a little touch, I've got sensitive balls. That's why I like them.
So why do you cough?
I found a lump. Do you think I have to stick?
Because if you touch it, if you like,
what? Like, you found
I found
a
lump.
What, bro? What's going on?
Is it?
Let's just end it.
Go hospital for that one, man. That's a hospital thing.
It is, isn't it?
A doctor thing.
Of course it is. You can't have three balls.
That's not even that. It's like a tumour.
He's trying to think of a joke.
Yeah. Fuck it, man. If I got
that's no, real, bro. Yeah. Let me feel them. Come.
Hold on.
He thinks I won't, but I will.
He will touch your balls.
No, because I want to know if I want to know Al is.
You sick. I love you, Steve. This is Enfield.
Bro, I would have felt. I don't want him to be ill. We're just saying how good well he's doing at 19. Let's make you know if I know we're doing GoFundMe page for Al.
But send him to the hospital. You don't have to touch his Supreme boxers.
You could have done it here instead of man baggy. Extra large shorts.
When you're trying to have a boy, I've been looking on the internet. What you
do? Do the Chinese calendar.
That is the new one. I've just found out recently. Knows, right?
Blood, if you intercourse on this day, then on this day you have a kid.
It's known. It's proven. It's proven.
It's like the Chinese burns. Thank you very much for tuning in to another episode of Gasworks. This really is the greatest show. Sex education, you know, parents' evening, all of that. Listen, life is too short.
Black Power, Liam Nelson.
I need to do these up again because
shout out Blaze Brown.
Oh, get that checked.
Shout out Blaze Belleville. Right, people, thank you very much.